Mr. Hancock, Mr. Hancock, have you seen the papers? Oh, Mr. Hancock, it's wonderful. It's happened.
Calm yourself, woman. Stop jumping up and down. You'll have the floor in.
I'm so excited. I've been hoping, dreaming that this might happen, and it has. Oh, Mr. Hancock, Mr. Hancock.
Will you stop jumping up and down? My boiled egg's running over the side of the shell. Pull yourself together, woman. Look at me vintage car table, Matt. Yoke all over the driving seat here. Contain yourself, madam.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Hancock, but it's so wonderful. I'm so happy I could throw my arms around you and kiss you.
You dare. You dare. Just touch me, that's all. Just lay one finger on me. Go on, go on. Get my Georgian toasting fork where you least expect it. I will not have my staff mauling me about. What's got into you? I hope it's not this spring rubbish starting up again. I had enough of you last year. The minute you saw a crocus sticking up out of the ground, you were off. Yes, and what a trail you blazed. Not a man in East Cheam was safe that week. The minute you roared into town, they all took to the hills. Why don't you stick to eating, something you understand?
High spirits has nothing to do with spring.
Oh, what is it then? You haven't been drinking my shaving lotion again, have you?
No, I have not. Haven't you read the papers?
No, Bill's got them.
I didn't know he could read.
He's got them over him. I pinched his blankets last night. Now, will you please tell me why you've gone berserk?
Oh, it's wonderful news. The Americans are coming to Cheam.
Oh. Well, that's me finished at the dance hall, then. I was doing very well down there. I had four birds there, one in each corner, and they never met each other. It was a perfect setup. Well, we locals have had it now, mate. Once that lot sail in, waving dirty great fistfuls of chewing gum about, makes my bag full of mint lumps seem quite rural.
Oh, it's not as bad as that. You'll still find a girl.
Don't you believe it? They don't leave a thing. There won't be any spare women for miles. It'll be like a field of corn after the locusts have gone through. Don't remember the last time they were here in 1945? And the last G.I. bride sailed, the only woman left round here was old Mrs. Cravat at the post office. And she was 79. She would have gone too, but she couldn't get up the gangplank. And now we've managed to build up a nice young crop of girls again for the home market. They wade in and bang, it's harvest time. It's not good enough, I shall complain to the vicar.
Well, I'm sorry, I think it's wonderful news.
Oh, well, you would. Like holding out a glass of water to a bloke lost in the desert. This is your big chance, isn't it? You've given up round here, they've rumbled you. Now a nice lot of fresh has arrived, you can't wait to get in amongst them, can you? As the poet has it, if Muhammad won't go to the mountain, then the mountain must go to Muhammad.
I don't quite care for your comparisons. You're just jealous. You don't want to see me get on, do you? You'd hate it if I married a rich American and he swept me off to his rich tobacco plantation in North Carolina, wouldn't you?
Look at this. Baby doll. No doubt you'll do very well. The minute they arrive, you'll be down outside the main gates with the rest of the females. High heels, ponytails, swinging your handbags. See the whole nauseating picture. What a painting for Peter Scott. British birds migrating for the winter. Led by a very fine specimen of the gannet.
You've got against Americans. You'll notice a big difference when they come. Your days are numbered.
Well, I wish they weren't coming. What are they here for, anyway?
They've come to defend us.
Defend us? Stone me, they'll want us to defend them when the likes of you get after them. It's not only the woman problem that bothers me. Their presence is going to be felt in other ways as well. They're loaded with money, you know.
I know.
Hey, Tom.
Well, well, he's up, and it's only 3:30 in the afternoon.
It's not. It's 7:30 in the morning.
He's been here 10 years, and he still won't alter his watch. can't convince him we're different to Australia.
Anyway, I haven't just got up. I've been down to the cafe for a cup of tea. It's a dirty trick.
What is?
He's put a sign in the window saying American spoken, and he's put his tea up to ninepence a cup.
You see, it started. The rot has set in. He won't allow us in there very shortly, you see. We'll be barred from our own cafes. When are they moving in?
They've already started. They're building a camp in the park.
The park? They can't take over the park. That's ours. The council have got their coat of arms done in multicoloured glads. They've no right to deprive us of our amenities. I'm very fond of our park. Sunday mornings isn't the same without a couple of goes on the roundabout and a slide down the chute when the keepers are not looking.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. They're our allies.
I've nothing against the Americans when they're in America. Don't even mind a few of them strolling through London taking photographs of Busby's. But I will not be occupied. I'll have nowhere to drink, no girl to take out, and nowhere to slide. What a future for a fun-loving youngster like me. Mark my words, the villagers aren't going to like this. There won't be a man in East Cheam who will welcome them.
Hey, Hancock, isn't it marvellous? The Yanks are coming. We're in the money, we're in the money.
Sid! Yeah? Sid, just a minute, Sid. Am I to take it that you approve of this invasion?
What? With all that hard currency flying around? Blimey, I'll have that dollar gap closed in 3 weeks. I got it all sorted out, son. I just bought 3 cellars in the High Street. You see the signs going up tomorrow. The Eisenhower Club, the New Yorker Bar and Grill, and the Plantation Room. And if they do as well as I expect, I'll have the Florida Room, the California Club, and the rest of the 48 states catered for in no time. Marvellous.
Hasn't it occurred to you that they will have their own clubs in the camp?
Oh, yeah, but they'll want somewhere where they can get off with the birds. And there were 4 trainloads of them arrived from London this morning. Things like this don't happen every day. Everybody's out to make the most of it, and I guarantee that I make more than anybody. I'm starting a new taxi service from the railway station to the camp. 45 shillings a head.
It's only half a mile.
So, when they find out, I'll bring it down a few, Bob. I'm also going to start a few sightseeing tours, 25 bob each.
Oh, come off it. There's nothing to see around here.
Yeah, but they don't know that till they've been, will they? I'm not looking for long-term fiddle, son. They won't be here forever. What a pity I can't get the best racket of all.
And what's that?
Flats, of course. Flats, boy. They won't all live in the camp. Most of them will have to find rooms. Oh, if I only had a big house. If only I had a little house I could clean up. Oh, if I only had a house like this one.
I think it's disgusting that British people should take advantage of these men. These unsuspecting soldiers away from home. Many thousands of miles away in a strange land. Many of them for the first time in their young lives. And they find themselves at the mercy of rogues and charlatans who've no compunction in cashing in on their gullibility and lack of knowledge of the country they're in. I find the whole situation repugnant. And I'm surprised that we British, who have a reputation for fair play, should stoop so low. How much do you reckon a room would fetch?
Let me see. 12 nicker a week at least.
Bill, out in the air raid shelter. Miss Pew, give the bed a turn and all the springs. Put this in the window. Room to let. Americans only. How noble are these brave lads to come and defend us. Gentlemen, a toast to Anglo-American relations and the continuation of the international crisis.
Hey, is he here yet, Tub?
No, Sid's bringing him round. Apparently, he's a 3-star major general from West Virginia. Earns about 225 a month. Pounds, that is. Ha ha. Never been in England before, so we ought to be able to swing something on him.
Sid's doing very well out of it, isn't he? He's opened accommodation bureau in the High Street. The Sydney James Accommodation Bureau for Americans. For every flat he finds, the soldier has to pay him the equivalent of the first 2 weeks' rent.
Oh, what a twister. Got the landlord paying him 2 weeks' rent as well.
Hey, how many Americans will be living down the street?
Let's see, there's 20 houses. That's the street. Okay, well, that's 410.
410?
Well, Mrs. Biggs has got 15 in. There's 3 in each bedroom, 2 in the loft, and 2 in her old man's room. He's out in the hen house. You can't buy a camp bed round here for miles. I don't know why some of these lads are moving in. I'm sure they got more room in their cars. Still, ours not to reason why, ours but to do.
You haven't finished it.
I think it's more appropriate to end there. A bigger lot of vultures I've never seen. Have you seen Miss Pugh?
Yeah, I saw her down the road with 3 Yanks.
Oh, Mr. Hancock, guess what? I'm getting married.
Stone me, they've only been here 2 hours.
It was love at first sight. He swept me off my feet.
What was he driving, a bulldozer?
Mrs. Alphonse G. Paparelli.
Pardon?
That'll be me, Griselda Paparelli the Third.
Has he got 2 others, then?
Well, he's been divorced twice. They didn't understand him.
Quite frankly, if he's going to marry you, neither do I.
Oh, isn't it wonderful? I'm going to be a GI bride. He's told me all about himself. He's got a huge country mansion ready for me. 10,000 head of cattle and 3 oil wells.
Where?
His hometown, Brooklyn.
Dear, oh dear, they're at it again. I think you'd have been better off with Charlie Harris, the milkman, you know. You should never have given him up. Just because he asked you to share a room with his horse, it was only temporary till he got his round worked up a bit.
I'm going to Brooklyn with Alphonse.
And good luck to you. We've exported some rubbish in our time, but stone me, nothing like this.
Hey, Tub, I think our lodger's arrived. An American car's just pulled up outside.
Show me where.
Look, there it is. See, that's the front of it over there. And if you come over to this other window, you can see the back of it down the street.
That's not one car, is it?
Of course it is.
How big a crew does it carry?
It's a beaut, isn't it?
Well, I think it's very flash and ostentatious, and I'm certainly not having that stuck outside my front door.
Why not?
It makes my motorbike look daft. He is coming in here, isn't he? You can't tell from where the car is. It could be any one of these 4 houses.
No, look. He's coming in the gate with Sid.
Right, straighten out the picture of Abraham Lincoln. Switch the other bar of the electric fire on. You know how they like a bit of central heating. And go out and make a pot full of America's favourite coffee. Here we go. Put the gramophone record on. Open the door.
23 railway cuttings. Hot in, shut.
Never mind, the thought was there. Welcome to England, Colonel. I hope your stay will be a long and happy one. It'll be 4 weeks' rent in advance. I don't mind it in dollars, is the receipt. I think you'll find it'll be quite...
Hold on. I haven't decided a ticket yet. I'm just looking around.
Well, you won't find a better residence than this in the whole of Cheam. Look, here's your receipt.
Mr. Hancock, please. We don't want to give our American ally here the impression that we're trying to get his money out of him now, do we?
Why, no, of course not.
There's so much of that sort of thing going on around here since you Americans arrived, Colonel.
Oh, yeah, so I believe.
Very lamentable. Mr. Hancock and myself want to make sure that you get the finest possible accommodation for the lowest possible rent.
Why, thank you, sir. I appreciate your consideration.
First, allow me to introduce the other members of the household. This is William, my Filipino houseboy. Yeah. Pull your eyes up a bit. He'll do all your running about and clean your shoes, washing and all the other dirty jobs, won't you, William?
No, I won't.
Well. Well, well, he's relapsed into his native tongue again. No, I won't. Yes. No, I won't. Yes, yes. Yes, yes, no, I won't. Yes. It's Filipino for it's a pleasure. Yes, yes. Very colourful, these Filipinos. You can't keep him out of his sarong in the summer. He's a card. He'll look after you. Just throw him a coconut now and again. He'll be your friend for life. Now, here's your rent book and your front door key.
No, I really would like to see the apartment.
It's a luxury apartment, I assure you. I had Oliver Messel down to design the whole room for you. Yes, Ollie came down. He's a good lad. Here's your rent book. All H-bombs left in the umbrella stand.
Now, please, could I see the apartment?
Yes. Now, how could I best describe it? Do you like brass?
Yeah.
That's your bed taken care of.
A brass bed?
Oh, it's antique. It's a genuine antique Queen Anne brass bedstead.
Antique? Well, that's different. I just love antiques.
Oh, good. Well, I don't mind showing you the room, then, this way. Right. Yes, yes. Of course, you'll have the run of the whole house. This is the lounge with its open fireplace. When we get your first week's rent, I'll have one put in. Notice the heavy beam wood ceiling. Those beams are reputed to come from the very barge that used to carry down the Thames no less a personage than Dorothy Tootin. This is the dining room here. Notice the very pronounced French Empire influence in this room.
Where?
On the mantelpiece is a postcard from Casablanca and a water bottle from Indochina. And this is your suite. Your suite here leads off the landing, see?
Oh, yes. I trust you're going to have a door put on.
Oh, you don't like the curtain drawn across it?
Well, I was rather hoping for some privacy.
Well, I'm sure there's a door laying about the garden somewhere. We'll have it up here and nailed on in no time. Might be a bit short. Where would you like the gap, at the top or the bottom? Straight through the curtain and there, behold, this is your apartment.
There we are, Colonel. Lovely, isn't it? A slice of old England.
Well, I must say, it's not quite like we're used to at home.
It's all here, a completely self-contained apartment, you see. Lounge, study, bedroom, dining room, bathroom and kitchen.
There's only one room.
Yes, it's combined. The bed's over there, there's a gas stove in the corner, a writing desk under the window, a settee over there and a wash basin over there.
Well, how much is this room?
15 guineas a week.
Is that all?
Pardon?
Well, most of my men around here are paying 20 guineas a week.
Are they? Yes. I'm glad you told me, because naturally I haven't included water, gas and electric in that price, which is another 5 guineas a week.
It's well worth it, Colonel, let me tell you. I'll turn the gas mantle up so you can have a better look. Look at that now. Dead homely, isn't it?
Is that mattress interior sprung?
No, I think most of them are exterior, but we can still see to that.
Well, I like to be warm. You do have central heating, of course.
Well, you can put the oil stove in the middle of the room. You can't get much more central than that, mate. Take a look at the furnishings. Genuine antiques, all of it.
That carpet's got a hole in it.
Of course it has. It's old. Surely don't expect us to have a carpet 500 years old mended. Just accept antiques for what they are. You wouldn't buy a Beethoven painting and then start having a go at it. The man's a Philistine.
Of course he is. He'll be asking next why you haven't done anything about that spring sticking out of the armchair.
Yeah, why haven't you?
My dear sir, that spring has been sticking out of that chair since Oliver Cromwell sat in it with his armor on. The place is steeped in history. Nell Gwynn used to come back and count out oranges, yeah? On that very table, Sir Francis Drake planned the Battle of Waterloo. You can see the burn marks made by his fags. This place will be the envy of your friend.
Yeah, well, I've got to stay somewhere. I'll take it. You can arrange for air conditioning, I suppose.
Well, we haven't got it at the moment, but my houseboy can run up the stairs every 5 minutes and swing the door about a bit. Here's your rent book, sign here, and the rest of your mates will be moving in with you tomorrow.
I beg your pardon?
You don't expect to have a gigantic suite like this to yourself. We've got 9 others moving in with you. It'll be all right. You sleep 5 one way, 5 the other, sardine fashion, you know. Now, we'll leave you. I'm sure you'd want to settle in.
Well, I'd like to have a bath.
Yes, that's $1 extra. There's a tin bath and a pump down the end of the garden. Feel free to use it any time you like. Till tea time, then. Pip-pip.
Oh, yeah. Pip-pip.
£255, £250, £255, 10 shillings. That's this week's rent all there. Take this to the bank, William.
I don't like going down the bank. It's so crowded these days, people putting money in.
Yes, William, Providence has been kind to us.
Well, hiya, cats. Gee, have I had a swell time down at the bass dance. Oh, gee, I met the craziest guy. Oh, man, what a gasser. He was really rocking there, man. We're going to get married.
That's the 7th one, isn't it, Tub?
No, 8. You were out last night. You missed one. Ernie Kovacski.
Oh, man, did we have a ball. You should think this guy's got the craziest face you ever saw. He's over the edge. This boy, I'd sure go for him like crazy.
Isn't it marvelous? Stick a chewing gum and 2 packets of long fags and she's gone.
He's taking me back stateside. He's from Gastonia, North Carolina. Oh, man, you wait till you meet this Harvey. He sure is the most. Oh, daddy-o.
All right, dear, go and have a lie down. She makes the 100 before they go. She'll still be left here.
Hancock. Oh, blimey, there you are. We're in dead trouble, boy.
What's wrong, Sid?
Have you still got those 10 Yanks staying here?
Yes.
In the one room?
Yes.
Oh, dear.
What's wrong?
The local authorities have found out how everybody's exploiting the Yanks. They're sending inspectors around. When I find out how much we've been charging, they'll nick us. 10 in a room at 20 guineas a night. Blimey, they'll sling a book at us.
Where are they?
They're in the street now. They've nicked off the landlords already. I got here as quick as I could. I'll be here any minute. Where are the Yanks?
They're on leave.
Good, we got to move fast. They got any spare uniforms upstairs?
Yes, I think so.
Right, come on. Bill, you too.
Good afternoon. I'm from the Ministry of Housing. I'm making certain inquiries as to the overcrowding and the overcharging of American servicemen in this area.
Yeah, well, that's crazy, Mac. Come right in and make yourself at home, huh? Yeah, sure. Yeah. I mean, you just come right in, huh? Yeah, sure. Fellas, there's a limey minister of housing or something. Come on in and meet the guys, huh?
Is the landlord at home, Mr. Hancock, I believe?
Yeah, well, no, Mac Hancock, he ain't here right now, but you just come right on in, just go right ahead, and you just ask all the questions you want me to, Mac, huh? Okay. I mean, you just go right ahead and do that, huh?
Yes, thank you. Now, according to information we have, there are 10 of your servicemen living here in one room.
Oh, no, that ain't right. That's just a bunch of vicious rumors put about by that old Mother Biggs who's had some of hers taken away. Oh, yes. That is it. No, sir. There's only the three of us here. That's all, fellas, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Allow me to introduce you to the fellas, huh? This is Lieutenant Schultz of the American Air Force.
Howdy, partner. It's nice of you to sort of mosey along the old corral. We just got out of the bunkhouse, and I'm aiming to get myself some chuck, so if you'd care to sit down and hold a log fire, I'd be proud to rustle you up some pork and beans, so hit your critter to the mantelpiece.
Shut up. Yeah, you gotta forgive Lieutenant Schultz. He watches a lot on television there. This is Quartermaster Sergeant Walofsky. Keep it short, Sergeant.
Aye.
Thank you. Now, just far away with your questions, Mac, huh?
Well, now, Colonel, how many men do you have billeted here?
Like I said, there's just us three.
And where is the landlord?
Oh, yeah, that sweet little old Hancock. Ain't he just the kindest man we ever seen, fellas?
He's
just the darnest little guy you ever saw. Nothing was too much for this sweet little guy. I cannot speak too highly of this saint. He is a credit, indeed a credit, nay, a credit to the British nation.
Really?
Yeah, we written to the Pentagon about him.
Yup, he threw open his little old corral to us and told us to hitch up our critters and mosey along to the old...
Yes, yeah, sure. Okay, yeah. Well, this Hancock has been just great, Mac. You tell your Ministry of Housing this guy is a model landlord and we Americans are very lucky to be living here.
Your accent's a bit strange, Colonel. I can't quite place it.
Oh, is it? Well, it's a sort of Nebraska mixed up with some California and a bit of Oregon with southern drawl and a slight touch of the method.
How much rent are you paying?
52 and six. £2, 12 shillings and 6 pennies a month between us. Is that expensive?
No, very cheap. A whole house for 52 and six a month.
Well, that's what we're paying, isn't it, fellas?
Yeah. You said it.
Yeah, that lovable little character Hancock would not take a penny more for this magnificent residence.
This magnificent? I'm almost tempted to sue him for charging 52 and six a month. Well, still, I suppose it's cheap even for this hole. Well, I won't trouble you gentlemen further. I might tell you, you've saved Mr. Hancock a lot of embarrassment. He'd have had to face a very severe penalty if the allegations had been true.
I'll get that. Yeah?
Colonel Wahlberg?
He's on leave. Yes, that's me, isn't it? Colonel Wahlberg, yes, that's me, son.
Practice emergency, sir. All personnel are to report to the base. You and your crew have got to take your bomber up, sir.
Take a bummer up? Take a bummer up, yeah.
General's order, sir.
Yeah, well, we'll be down later. We're in the boys.
Well, it's an emergency, sir.
Yeah, we haven't got a car, see?
Pleased to take you all down in my car to the airfield.
Oh, shucks, don't put you out.
It's an emergency, sir.
I insist on driving you down. No trouble at all.
If I come with you, you can drive right up to the plane. You got to be airborne in 3 minutes. That's what we've been waiting for.
It might be what you've been waiting for. just one moment, Lieutenant. I wish to confer with my fellow officers. Who knows how to fly a plane?
I don't.
And I don't.
Well, it's either go up or go inside.
Off we go into the wild blue yonder, acting boys into the sun.
This is the BBC Light Program. Here is the news. Last night, a squadron of bomber planes from the American Strategic Air Force took off on a practice exercise. One of them is missing. It was last seen looping the loop at 30,000 feet before climbing vertically at 1,500 miles an hour and disappearing upside down over the Yorkshire Moor. This afternoon, a duck held up traffic on Westminster Bridge. All of the police to leave it for the street.
Sid, how do you get the thing down?
Well, the only way I know, boys, is to wait till it runs out of petrol. Here, what's that great big thing down there in the Bombay?
Hiya, fellas. You gonna take me stateside, huh? I'm just crazy mad about Americans.
Oh, stone me, it's her. She won't give up, will she? Bill, press that button. Get rid of her.
Now, wait a minute. Wait. Well, look, there's an aerodrome down here. Look, a deserted RAF drone.
Oh, good. Ah, where's the logbook? Here we are. Ah, it's how to land. Slow down. Press lever B. B, yes. Pull lever A. Press the green button. Let the wheels down.
Good evening.
Can you tell us where we are?
You're miles from anywhere. Right out on the moors you are.
Perhaps you could put us up for the night.
Certainly. Here they're American uniforms you got on, ain't they?
Yes, that's right.
That'll be 20 guineas a night each.
Shot with me own gun.
Very good rooms. All antiques. You Americans like antiques, don't you?
I bet you got a genuine Queen Anne brass bedstead, haven't you?
Yes, I am.
I thought you would have.
And a bath.
Don't tell me, with a pump at the end of the garden.
That's right.
Which is 5 bob extra?
Yes.
You're wasted down here, you know. You'd be a sensation in London, you would. Come on, let's get in the wall.